I, K.W. Bhutia, Registrar General, High Court of Sikkim, would like to take permission from Honorable the Chief Justice to begin today's full court federal reference. The federal reference will start as per the program schedule that we have circulated earlier. May I now request Honorable Mrs. Justice Meenakshi Madan Rai, Judge High Court of Sikkim, to kindly place her ladyship's address.
Honorable Sir Justice Jitendra Kumar Maheshwari, Chief Justice and Honorable Judge Designate Supreme Court of India, my brother Judge, Honorable Sir Justice Bhaskar Raj Pradhan. Honorable Sir Justice Jitendra Kumar Maheshwari, Chief Justice and Honorable Judge Designate Supreme Court of India, my brother Judge, Honorable Sri Justice Bhaskar Raj Pradhan, Honorable Sri Justice A.P. Subba, Chairman, Lokayukta, Sikkim, and former Judge, High Courts of Sikkim and Guwahati, Mrs. Uma Maheshwari, spouse of Honorable the Chief Justice, Mr. Roger Randip Rai, former Managing Director, Sikkim Industrial Development Corporation, and Mrs. Manasa Priyadarshana Pradhan, learned additional advocate generals, learned Registrar General and Registrar of the High Court of Sikkim, Mr. Prajwal Khatiwara, learned District and Sessions Judge, East District, all learned judicial officers of the East District, learned senior advocates and other members of the Bar, all office bearers of the Bar Association of Sikkim and High Court Bar Association, officers and staff of the High Court Registry, Sikkim State Legal Services Authority and Sikkim Judicial Academy, Mr. Manu Maheshwari and Mr. Ankur Maheshwari, members of the print and electronic media, ladies and gentlemen. As we assemble here this morning, we are in the midst of history being created. We are all aware that the High Court of Judicature of Sikkim was established on 17 April 1955 by a proclamation, that is the High Court of Judicature Jurisdiction and Powers Proclamation 1955 by the then Chogyal of Sikkim, Sir Tashi Namgyal. It has stood sentinel for 66 years, 46 of which after Sikkim became part of the Indian Union, to the coming and going of several Chief Justices. All have been persons of capability and competence, but we have not had the privilege of having an Honorable Chief Justice or Judge of this High Court ever being elevated to the Honorable Supreme Court of India and adorning the bench there. Thus, for the first time in the history of not only this High Court, but in the history of Sikkim, the Chief Justice of this High Court, Honorable Sri Justice Jitendra Kumar Maheshwari, is being elevated to the Honorable Supreme Court of India. His Lordship was elevated as Additional Judge of the High Court of Madhya Pradesh on 25th November 2005 and was made Permanent Judge on 25th November 2008. Till September 2019, he was Judge of the Madhya Pradesh High Court and thereafter elevated as Chief Justice and transferred to the High Court of Andhra Pradesh on 7th October 2019, where he continued till he was transferred and took oath as the Chief Justice of the Honorable High Court of Sikkim on 6th January 2021. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, this court has not been able to hold physical hearings, and attempts to that end were made for a few days from 30th March 2021 to 27th April 2021. On lockdown being reimposed by the state on 27th April 2021, we have been working online since. We have consequently not had the privilege of having frequent interactions with His Lordship. Nevertheless, through the limited interactions, we have come to learn that he is an amiable personality, a thorough professional, and a competent judge. It is evident that he was actively involved in the improvement of administration and judicial functioning of the high courts that he has manned. In Madhya Pradesh High Court, as the first puni judge, he was assigned responsibilities in various committees, such as the Member Administrative Committee No. 1, Higher Judicial Service, Chairperson, Member, Building Committee for Building Construction and Maintenance, Chairperson, Finance Committee, Chairperson, Juvenile Justice Committee, Madhya Pradesh High Court, for monitoring the functioning of the juvenile justice issues in the state of Madhya Pradesh. Member of the committee to recommend the names of advocates for the designation as senior advocate. Member of committee which was involved in comprehensive studies and analysis on the courts of Madhya Pradesh, past and present. Various other assignments as assigned by Honorable the then Chief Justice of Madhya Pradesh High Court. His Lordship was also nominated member of Academic Council, National Law Institute, University, Bhopal. In the newly established High Court of Andhra Pradesh, His Lordship was instrumental in having identified land and completing construction of the Chief Justice's bungalow, Vijayawada, Andhra Pradesh. He also took steps for establishment of the Gram Nyayalayas in the state and framed rules thereof. He was actively involved in the constitution of several subcommittees in that High Court to streamline its working, which included subcommittees for preparation of draft rules for retired judges, for the High Court staff, as well as staff of the trial courts. Noticeably, gender sensitization rules were prepared by the subcommittee constituted for the purpose, as also guidelines for dealing with complaints against judicial officers of the state. Necessary steps were taken by him for recruitment of the High Court staff and staff in the subordinate courts due to bifurcation and establishment of the new High Court of Andhra Pradesh. Since the High Court of Andhra Pradesh, as already stated, was at its nascent stage, steps were taken for establishment of the Judicial Academy by His Lordship. E-filing module was developed and mobile internet was adopted for users with slow internet speed to upload the data to the National Judicial Data Grid. In the midst of the pandemic, safety measures were taken to ensure the well-being of stakeholders and safety of the High Court to deal with the COVID-19 situation. His Lordship has also passed judgments of importance on the point of limitation during the COVID-19 pandemic in the High Court of Andhra Pradesh, reported in 2020, within brackets 2, Andhra Law Times 493, on arbitration and conciliation, the Hindu Marriage Act, interpretation of statutes, and a plethora of other legal issues and provisions. During His Lordship's tenure here, we have identified land for construction of the High Court, as we are now in cramped quarters and require bigger and better infrastructure for the judges, as well as the officers and staff, and of course the learned advocates. Despite the unrelenting monsoon rains, on his insistence, we scouted for land and were successful in locating one for construction of a more spacious High Court with the required infrastructure. A few days ago, while notification for His Lordship's elevation was being uploaded by the Ministry of Law and Justice on its web portal, he was out in the rain looking for land for the establishment of a national law university in Sikkim. His efforts are aimed at the betterment of the judicial infrastructure in Sikkim and also for the betterment for legal education in Sikkim, more especially to enable the imparting of quality legal education to children who opt to study law. Although His Lordship was the patron in chief of the Sikkim State Legal Services Authority, he has allowed me a free hand as the executive chairperson to continue my workings in the state legal services with no interference whatsoever, and has been appreciative of the works that has been done by the State Legal Services Authority. After 16 years of service in the judiciary as judge and thereafter chief justice of various high courts, his elevation to the Honorable Supreme Court is indeed well deserved, considering his conscientious and diligent work in the high courts that he has adorned. I conclude my address with the promise that God has given in the Bible for protection of your lordship. This is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse 2. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. When you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze. In keeping with those blessings, we wish you success in all your future endeavors, coupled with good health, happiness, and peace of mind. Thank you.
Thank you. Honorable Chief Justice, High Court of Sikkim. Honorable Mrs. Justice Meenakshi Madan Rai, Judge, High Court of Sikkim. Honorable Justice A.P. Subba, Chairperson Lokayukta. Madam Uma Maheshwari, Mr. Roger R. Rai, Mrs. Manasha Priyadarshana Pradhan, Dr. Domati Bhutia and Mr. Sudesh Joshi, the Learned Advocate, Additional Advocate Generals, Learned Registrar General and the Learned Registrar, Learned Senior Advocates, Learned Judges of the District Judiciary, the Learned Law Secretary, the Learned Member Secretary, Sikkim Legal Services Authority, the Learned Director and Additional Director, Sikkim Judicial Academy, the Learned President and Executive Members of the Bar, and the Learned Advocates, Mrs. Matilda Isaac, Special Secretary, Sikkim State Legal Services Authority, all officers and staff of the High Court of Registry, SJA and SSLSA, members of the press and media. The Honorable Chief Justice is leaving us too soon. However, in his parting, we must rejoice as he is the first Chief Justice of the High Court of Sikkim to be elevated to the Apex Court. In this short period, I have seen him as a man with certainty of purpose and definite with his views. What is even more noticeable is the fact that he has been able to reach the highest court of justice while hailing from a relatively small township. From Jaora to the Honorable Supreme Court of India, his journey is to be reckoned with. The young aspiring lawyers and judges from Sikkim should keep his journey as an inspiration to work hard, dream big, and achieve what may seem impossible. My interaction with the Honorable Chief Justice was restricted even more due to the pandemic. In my limited interactions in the courtroom and while we worked on the phase two project of the Sikkim Judicial Academy, I realized he is one with great experience, not only in the judicial field, but also in administration and creation of judicial infrastructure. In the courtroom, I noticed a judge who, powered by his experience as a highly successful lawyer of 19 years standing and more than 16 years as a judge, was quick to grasp the issues and unhesitant to pronounce judgment. When he entered the courtroom, I was certain that he has read his brief and was well prepared to ask the right questions and decide the pivotal issues. The Honorable Chief Justice has started a lot of beneficial projects for the High Court of Sikkim. Many of them are now in the implementation stage, and we hope to complete all of them in right earnest. I got the opportunity to meet and interact with Madam Uma Maheshwari only briefly. However, it was enough to gauge that she was a strong pillar of strength for the Honorable Chief Justice. Their son, Mr. Manu Maheshwari, is a young budding lawyer about to start his life. Mr. Ankur Maheshwari, their nephew, is also with us today, is also a young, successful lawyer. I would like to end my reference by wishing the Honorable Chief Justice great success in his 4 years and 10 months stint in the Supreme Court of India. I do hope you author many landmark judgments to guide us. I also wish and hope that you will be able to impart justice to the common man and make a difference to their lives. I wish Madam Uma Maheshwari, Mr. Manu Maheshwari, Ms. Diksha, and Mr. Ankur Maheshwari great happiness and success in all their endeavors. Thank you.
My Lord, the Honorable Chief Justice, Honorable Justice Meenakshi Madan Rai, Honorable Justice Bhaskar Pradhan, Learned Registrar General, Registrar, My Lord, Justice A.P. Subba, Learned Judicial Officers, my brother and sisters, colleagues at bar, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to all. The elevation of my Lord, the Chief Justice, to the Honorable Supreme Court is a moment of immense pride and honor for all the members of legal fraternity of Sikkim and this Honorable Court. With this accomplishment of my Lord, the Chief Justice, another milestone has been achieved as my Lord, the Chief Justice, becomes the first judge from the Honorable High Court of Sikkim to be elevated to the Honorable Apex Court of the Nation. someone asked William Shakespeare about destiny, and he explained it in simple words. It is not in the stars to hold our destiny, but in ourselves. My Lord, the Chief Justice, being the first judge from the Honorable Sikkim High Court to be elevated to Supreme Court, has left to posterity not only footsteps to follow, but also an inspiration to create your own destiny. We have all been introduced to my Lord's journey till now. Born in Jaora, Morena District, Madhya Pradesh in the year 1961, his lordship completed LLB in the year 1985 and LLM from Jiwaji University, Gwalior in the year 1991. His lordship was elevated as the additional judge of the Madhya Pradesh High Court on November 25, 2005 and was made permanent on 25th November 2008. His lordship has disposed of more than 65,000 cases while sitting in Indore bench, Gwalior bench, and principal seat at Jabalpur, and no kadalats held by High Court of Madhya Pradesh from time to time. There are quite a few firsts attached to his lordship. To name a few, my Lord was the first Chief Justice of the newly established Andhra Pradesh High Court. During his tenure of 15 months in the High Court of Andhra Pradesh, his lordship disposed of more than 4,500 cases. Under the leadership of his lordship, the High Court of Andhra Pradesh started virtual court on 25/3/2020. It was the first High Court to hear cases by virtual mode at that time. Having assumed the office of Chief Justice of Sikkim High Court, his lordship is the first judge from our High Court to be elevated to the Honorable Supreme Court. Although my Lord, the Chief Justice's time in this Honorable Court has been short, but the impact my Lord's left will be remembered for time to come. My Lord's legal ingenuousness, eloquence, knowledge and perceptiveness is the reason why my Lord is able to, with remarkable ease, decide the most complex issues. My Lord has always exercised balance and equity in all respects. My Lord's judgments are proof that judicial pronouncements are not rendered only on facts and law, but upon pragmatic determination of its implication on the society. My Lord, I humbly express my gratitude to you for not just leaving a mark on the judicial system, but for leaving a mark in our hearts. We wish you all the success and luck, and are confident that you will be adding laurels to the apex court just as you have in all other courts.
Honorable Chief Justice Sri Jitendra Kumar Maheshwari and Madam Maheshwari, Honorable Justice Meenakshi Madan Rai and Sir Mr. Rai, Honorable Justice Bhaskar Raj Pradhan and Madam Pradhan, Honorable Justice A.P. Supa, former Judge of the High Court of Sikkim and a Chairperson of Sikkim Lokayukta, Learned Ashu A.G., my young colleague, Learned Registrar General and Learned Registrar, Learned President of the Bar, Honorable Judges of the Subordinate Courts, Learned Senior Advocates, Member of the Bar at the High Court and the Subordinate Court of Sikkim, Staff of the High Court Registry, and the legal aid service authorities, and my esteemed brother and sister. First of all, on behalf of the Sikkim High Court Bar Association as president and in my capacity as the additional advocate general of the state of Sikkim, I express my gratitude to our High Court for an opportunity bestowed upon me to address for federal reference the speech on this auspicious occasion. Now coming to the lordship's end. We are assembled here today to witness and recount our happiness and our pride on the occasion of full court farewell of our Honorable Chief Justice, Justice Sri Maheshwari, on his being elevated as a judge to the Honorable Supreme Court of India. It is a historical occasion for us. My Lord Chief Justice, Justice Maheshwari, has created a new chapter in the history of High Court of Sikkim, being the first Chief Justice who has been elevated to Honorable Supreme. A happy moment indeed for us, and yet a moment of sadness as well. For what shall be lost to us in missing on his lordship's vast experience that guided us during his short tenure at the High Court of Sikkim? Entire country would now gain from his lordship's wisdom during his stint at the Supreme Court. His lordship, Justice Maheshwari, is a real example of what it is called as a human touch to the tough work of a judge, simple in his demeanor and courteous in his approach to one and all. Honorable Chief Justice, Maheshwari has been helpful to all of us as a human being outside the court, yet his interactions off the court with anybody never reflected on his clinical exercise of his judgeship in the court. We, the advocate practicing in the High Court of City, he defeated from among not legal acumen and sense of justice arising out of his long year of practice at a bar and later his long tenure as a High Court judge, his pointed queries during the hearing and simple worded, clearly directed and easily understood order will be remembered by members of the bar lordship. We shall remember his lordship as being supportively guiding the building institution of importance, such as recognizing granted to Supreme Court of Bar as granting the exclusive power of the advocate practicing in the High Court of City. A much felt need was fulfilled during a short tenure of his lordship at City. Honorable Chief Justice Maheshwari also led us towards the idea of setting up a national law university in the state of City and having a High Court premises befitting the stature of our High Court. We shall be looking forward to his continued guidance and support toward fruition of this sibling endeavor. His lordship will stay in our good thoughts for declaring the lawyer, judges and the staff of the judiciary as a frontline workers during the second wave of COVID-19 and getting them vaccinated on a priority basis. We wish his lordship a successful tenure at the Honorable Supreme Court. We wish him a happy and healthy life. We will look forward to his guidance and support in the years to come.
My Lord, our Honorable Chief Justice, my Lord, Mr. Justice Meenakshi Prasad Rai, my Lord, Mr. Justice Bhaskar Raj Pradhan, Honorable Judge Justice E.P. Subba, Chairman, Lok Ayukta, Madam Uma Maheshwari, Sir Mr. Roger Rai, Madam Meenakshi, Manisha Riya Darshani Pradhan, as I stand here today, it's a special feeling of joy and a moment we are all proud of. I'm here to be a part of history, a history till date. No one had created a history which we all thought was not possible, but one which we all desired and hoped for. And today, with the elevation of my Lord to the Honorable Chief, Supreme Court, there is a sense of joy, a moment that we will all take in and feel proud about. And this is not only the feeling within the judiciary, but the entire state. And I must tell my Lord that this is a feeling that comes straight from our heart. I am sure my Lord's family and the entire state of Madhya Pradesh feels the same. I can only compare this moment when Neeraj Chopra recently won first gold medal for India in the recent Olympic Games. We are all so grateful to my Lord for his dynamic thought to have a state-of-the-art courts, be it the High Court or the District Courts. What bears in each and every member of the Bar Association of Sikkim, senior and junior, is the fact that our Chief Justice has been elevated to the Honorable Supreme Court, and this for the first time in almost 70 years of our history. We all are proud of my Lord, and we all wish my Lord and his family good health and happiness.
My Lords and Ladies, I take this opportunity to express my immense pleasure and happiness in addressing this honorable full court today. My Lords and Your Ladies, today I proudly feel like I am addressing before the Honorable Supreme Court of India. I find no difference today. The glory of this Honorable High Court has definitely increased when the Honorable the Chief Justice, Sri Justice Jitendra Kumar Maheshwari, is leaving this court to join the highest court of the country. Honorable Sri Justice Jitendra Kumar Maheshwari was sworn in as the Chief Justice of our High Court in January this year. However, we could appear and make our submissions in the video conferencing mode due to the devastating pandemic of COVID-19. However, we thoroughly enjoyed the hearing, even in the video conference, and the way of hearing and quick disposal of the cases before this Honorable High Court. His Lordship, Sri Justice Jitendra Kumar Maheshwari, disposed of many old pending cases, including some public interest litigations. In the final hearings, Your Lordship used to hear the petitioners only in case the other side is able to make out his case. His Lordship has the habit of bringing the counsel appearing before him right to the point without wasting the time in submissions of other irrelevant matters. At that time, His Lordship used to be cordial and patient during the time of hearing. This would definitely save the valuable public time in the courts. Thus, we can simply guess that His Lordship, Sri Justice Jitendra Kumar Maheshwari, shall adore the Honorable Supreme Court of India as a perfect judge. His Lordship's elevation to the Honorable Supreme Court of India, particularly from the High Court of Sikkim, is a matter of pride to the state of Sikkim, Bar Association of Sikkim, and the people of Sikkim. The elevation of Honorable Justice of this Honorable High Court to the Honorable Supreme Court is also a new record for the Honorable High Court of Sikkim and the entire state, as well as for the Bar Association of Sikkim and for the civil society. We would like to sincerely thank Your Lordship, Sri Justice Jitendra Kumar Maheshwari, for creating a record and history for us. We will deeply miss Your Lordship in this High Court. However, we may have an opportunity to appear before Your Lordship in the Honorable Supreme Court of India in some cases. We, the members of the Bar, congratulate Your Lordship, the Chief Justice of this Honorable High Court, for his deserving elevation to the judge of the Honorable Supreme Court of India. We also wish Your Lordship every success for the excellent service career as a judge of the apex court of the country. I am certain that Dev and Devis of this holy state will always bless Your Lordship for a very successful career as the judge of the Honorable Supreme Court. May the blessings of Mother Deity keep Your Lordship, Madam, and children in the best of your health in days to come. Thank you.
Honorable the Chief Justice and Honorable Judge Designate Supreme Court of India, Honorable Madam Justice and other family members, Honorable Mrs. Justice Meenakshi Madan Rai, Sir Justice, Honorable Justice Bhaskar Raj Pradhan, Madam Justice, Honorable Mr. Justice A.P. Subha, former Judge of this Honorable High Court and Chairperson Lokayuk, Learned Additional Advocate General, Learned Senior Advocates, Learned Judicial Members, Learned Members of Bar, Office Bearers and Staff of this Court, ladies and gentlemen. Today we have assembled here to bid farewell to Honorable Mr. Justice Jitendra Kumar Maheshwari, Honorable the Chief Justice of this Honorable Court, being elevated to the Honorable Supreme Court of India, creating history for state judiciary and entire state of Sikkim. His Lordship was born on 29 June 1961 in the town of Jawara, Madhya Pradesh. His Lordship graduated in arts in 1982 and passed LLB in 1985 and LLM in 1991 from Jiwai University, Gwalior. His Lordship was enrolled as an advocate with the State Bar Council of Madhya Pradesh on November 22, 1985, and practiced in different branches of law, and in particular civil, criminal, constitutional, service and tax matters in High Court of Madhya Pradesh, mainly at Gwalior branch and principal seat at Jabalpur and Honorable Supreme Court of India. His Lordship appeared before the Central Administrative Tribunal and various other tribunals in the state of Madhya Pradesh, His Lordship was also a member of the Madhya Pradesh State Bar Council from the year 2002 till his elevation to the bench and was chairman of disciplinary committee, Gwalior bench, and worked in various other committees of MP State Bar Council. His Lordship was elevated to the bench as additional judge of High Court of Madhya Pradesh on November 25, 2005 and was appointed as permanent judge on November 25, 2008. His Lordship participated in various national conferences from time to time when in Madhya Pradesh High Court. His Lordship had disposed of more than 65,000 cases during his tenure in Indore bench, Gwalior bench, principal seat at Jabalpur and Lok Adalat held by High Court of Madhya Pradesh from time to time. His Lordship was transferred as Chief Justice of Andhra Pradesh High Court and assumed office on October 7, 2019, becoming the first Chief Justice of the newly established High Court of Andhra Pradesh. Despite His Lordship's short stint of 15 months at the Andhra Pradesh High Court, more than 4,500 cases were disposed of, which also saw the High Court of Andhra Pradesh become the first High Court to hear matters by virtual mode on 25th of March 2020. His Lordship was subsequently transferred and assumed office as Chief Justice of this Honorable Court on 6th of January 2021. Though this nearly 8 months since, it has been a very memorable experience to assist His Lordship in dealing with the different matters that have been brought up before this Honorable Court. His Lordship's immaculate sense of judicial propriety and distinctive way of dealing, which have resulted in speedy disposal of 69 cases, even in the midst of this pandemic, have all been an enchanting experience for me. His Lordship will bid adieu to this institution after having a tenure of little more than 8 months. Position of balanced combination of inherent and acquired qualities make His Lordship a great John and a great human being. We will miss His Lordship's presence in this institution. However, Lordship will always remain as inseparable part of this judiciary of the state and will be remembered with love and respect in all times to come. I pray to the Almighty for the good health of His Lordship and his loved ones as His Lordship embarks on this special journey forward to the highest court of the land and wish him the best for the times to come. Thank you.
It is well said by Joseph Story, Judge, U.S. Supreme Court, that without justice being freely, fully, and impartially administered, neither our persons, nor our rights, nor our property can be protected. And if these are, either of them, are regulated by no certain laws and are subject to no certain principles and are held by no certain tenure and are redressed when violated by no certain remedies, society fails to all its value and man may as well return to the state of savage and barbarous independence. My esteemed sister and brother judges on the bench, Justice A.P. Subba, Lokayukt, State of Sikkim, Learned Additional Advocate Generals, Presidents, Sikkim High Court Bar Association and Bar Association of Sikkim, and Office Bearer of their respective Bar Associations, Learned Senior Advocates and Members of the Bar, Respected Mrs. Maheshwari, Mr. Roy, Mrs. Pradhan, my family members and guests, Learned Registrar General and Registrar of the High Court, Legal Remembrance cum Secretary, Law Department, Government of Sikkim, Member Secretary, State Legal Services Authority, State of Sikkim and their staff, Director and Additional Director of the Judicial Academy and their staff, Assistant Solicitor General of the State of Sikkim. Learned judicial officers, officers and staff of the registry, members of the press and electronic media, ladies and gentlemen who join this function. I am here before you today humble and in awe that so many of you considered my farewell ceremony on my elevation worthy of your time. I am deeply touched and overwhelmed by the kind words that you have all expressed today for me and think whether I deserve for, albeit I convey my gratitude to all of you. Prior to joining as Chief Justice of High Court of Sikkim and on tracing the establishment of the High Court, it was found that on 17th of April 1955, this prestigious High Court of Sikkim was established by proclamation in the name of the High Court of Judicature, Jurisdiction and Power Proclamation 1955, proclaimed by the then Maharaja of Sikkim, who was known as Chogyal. On merger with the Indian Union by virtue of 36th Constitutional Amendment Act, Sikkim was made 22nd state under Article 371F of the Constitution of India in 1975. The High Court of Judicature becomes the High Court of Sikkim with the effect from 26th April 1975. On assuming the office of the Chief Justice on 6th of January 2021 till now, though my tenure was short but is full of satisfaction and I am feeling proud and privileged to have presided over the High Court of Sikkim, being the custodian of the judiciary of the state, which has paramount importance with glorious history of its own and the goal-oriented approach. It is only the judiciary that can firmly stand for constitutional morality. Fortunately, the High Court of Sikkim has great traditions and playing vital role in discharge of its duties and responsibilities with dedication. It is my firm belief that the legal system can only work with the cooperation of the bar and the bench and dedicated staff. We are proud to be a part of most reputed and responsible institution like High Court. In the said context, it is my experience here, honorable judges, are courteous and composed. My journey being Chief Justice of this court is incomplete without acknowledging the valuable cooperation and support of them. They gave me the support and suggestions to fulfill my duties both on judicial and administrative side. The greatest strength of the judiciary is the faith of the people on the justice delivery system. It is said that the deed cannot cry out for justice. It is the duty of the living to do so for them. In discharge of the duties, I found members of the judicial fraternity are well known for its partiality and independence. The independence of the judiciary is paramount to maintain rule of law and to those who knock the door of justice. A strong judiciary is one of the estates of the democracy, having great bearing on the lives of people. Senior lawyers are known to build the legal fraternity and are essential for effective dispensation of justice. At the same time, the junior lawyers are seekers, but their role is of immense significance for upliftment of justice delivery system. While communicating my respect to senior members, I expect their genuine support to develop the institution and to bring it up on a high pedestal, being a torchbearer of the fraternity. Therefore, being pioneers, they have to play a great role to inspire the budding lawyers. On this occasion, I wish to have some suggestions to the young advocates. Hard labor only is the key of success. There is no shortcut in life, so please work hard with devotion. Your work must start from commitment with diligence to acquire excellence. In this journey to build the legal fraternity, the advocate, be it senior or junior, must follow the ethics, moral values, time management, technological advancement. Looking to the present experience gained by all of us on account of surge of COVID-19 pandemic, the technology became tool in dispensation of justice. So it is my earnest suggestions that the juniors must pay respect to senior members of the bar, and seniors ought to have accepted the juniors as a member of their family and to work in one tandem to achieve the excellence in profession with ethical standards. For moral of advocates, Honorable Apex Court said, the high moral tone and the considerable public service the bar is associated with, and its key role in the developmental and dispute processing activities, and above all in the building up of the just society and constitutional order, has earned for its monopoly in practice law and an autonomy to regulate its own internal discipline. So I request to all the members of the bar, please follow our ethics and morals and do for the society. It is my duty to have some suggestions to the judicial officers. The Apex Court in the judgment of the Bar Council of the Maharashtra versus M.B. Dabholkar, a 1976 Supreme Court 242, specified the role and qualities of the judicial officers. Judicial officers are in fact flag bearers of the legal profession. The sincerity towards their profession, irrespective of the pressure, sets the bench mark for the future, which enables to repose trust and faith in the judiciary. The duty of the judge is to impart justice fairly and with utmost sincerity and honesty. Indian Constitution provides for an independent judiciary. Judicial officers are one of the strongest pillars of the justice delivery system. They must have the quality of patience, understanding, and courtesy. Judicial officers should discharge their duties with honesty and have to uphold the constitutional values for effective dispensation of justice. In addition, the noble soul, late APJ Abdul Kalam, former President of India, advice to the judges in his words as thus, I quote, the profession of a judge is very novel and divine, and the members of the judiciary therefore become inviolable role models, the perfect incorruptible ideals of a civilized society. I also wish to give some advice to the staff of the court to work with integrity, devotion, and by use of technology to ascertain the functioning of the courts. Their efficient functioning shall make them different from others. So please make a mark, thereby our functioning may be recognized in dispensation of justice, enhancing justice delivery system. Now it is a time to give my sincere thanks to all of them who have supported me directly or by their indirect gesture, even on my shortcomings. I believe in a superpower governing all mankind and its actions. Whenever I was in crossroads, I had left the decision on that superpower, for he knows best what is best bestowed. It was the superpower which brought me here. You have received me with greatest affection and love. You never made me feel as I am outsider, and my family made to feel one among you. That is magnanimous and generous on your part, something which I will never ever forget. In the last about 8 months of my working here, I received unprecedented support from my esteemed colleagues. I had precious assistance and support from the Registrar General and Registrar of this court in discharge of both judicial and administrative duties. It would not be possible for me to mention each and every officer and staff of this registry by name, but I am grateful to every single person for giving me either constant support and assistance. I would like to extend my humble gratitude to all the protocol staff who were available to serve me and my guests coming from different corners. Similarly, I am also thankful to doctors and health workers for taking care of my health. I would be failing in my duties if I do not accept the valuable service given to me by my personal staff attached to my office and residence. I am also thankful to the state of Sikkim for providing excellent support and security to me throughout my tenure. I try to keep calmness while discharging all my duties. If at all, at any point of time, I was harsh and pained anybody, it was only in the interest of institution and also for dispensation of justice, but not otherwise. Suppose I offended anyone at any point of time during my tenure, please forgive me, since it is unintentional. I cannot forget to acknowledge the unconditional support given by my wife and family members who were always there to support me even in my difficult time. My family members and I take back sweet memories during the period of stay here and feel blessed by the love and affection showered on us by all of you and by nature and environment. I am leaving this institution with a wealth of knowledge which will always be treasure to me. It is well said by Ernie Harvey that it's a time to say goodbye. But I think goodbye are said, and I had much rather say hello. Hello to a new adventure. How we have to work in future may reflect from some couplet which I will quote. Haath thamna jaruri hai. हाथ थामना जरूरी है, फर्क नहीं पड़ता कि आगे तुम चलो या मैं. साथ होना जरूरी है, फर्क नहीं पड़ता तुम संभलो या मैं. I wish all of you to do the best in their future endeavor. May the blessings of Almighty be showered upon all of us. I would like to quote the famous line of Liza Minnelli. Dream on it. Let your mind take you to places you would like to go. And then think about it and plan it and celebrate the possibilities. And don't listen to anyone who doesn't know how to dream. Thank you very much to all of you. Jai Hind.
I take permission from Honorable the Chief Justice to close the proceedings. I declare the full court reference to be closed. Apart from this, I'd like to request all the invitees to join us for high tea in the banquet hall, please.